मिशन इस्तांबुल इज ए 2008 इंडियन हिंदी लैंग्वेज एक्शन थ्रिलर फिल्म स्टारिंग विवेक ओबराय, श्रेया सारन एंड जाहिद खान इन द लीड रोल्स। द फिल्म डायरेक्टेड बाय अपूर्वा लाखिया फीचर अभिषेक बच्चन इन एन स्पेशल अपीयरेंस। द फिल्म इज बेस्ड ऑन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ए आई जोहारा विच बेयर्स अ रेजेंबलेंस टू कतार बेस्ड न्यूज चैनल ए आई जजीरा विच वॉज क्रिटिसाइज बाई द व्हाइट हाउस एज बींग एन आउटलेट फॉर टेररिस्ट। द फिल्म डील्स विद द रोल ऑफ ए आई जोहरा बेस्ड इन तुर्की ए एन एनेटियो काउंटी विद द ट्रूप्स एंगेज इन अफगानिस्तान एंड द रोल ऑफ द इंडियन इंटेलिजेंस एजेंसी आर ए डब्ल्यू रॉ। द प्लॉट ऑफ द मूवी वॉज रियली वेरी ग्रेट। द स्टोरी इज बेस्ड ऑन द लाइफ ऑफ इंडिया टॉप न्यूज रिपोर्टर विकास सागर जैद खान who he would do anything for his news report, even risk his life. Ambitious, popular and professional, Vikas is considered one of the most promising journalists in the business. Due to this reason, Uwais Hasan Sunil Shetty, a senior producer at the controversial news channel AI Zahara, and offers him a job as the head of the channel's India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. while running from gunmen, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up gunmen and removes that trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zahra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists, and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zahra and rifled off a list of AI Zahra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zahra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zahra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorist attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. देर इज ओनली वन वर्ड ऑफ कॉशन टू विकास एंड लेट्स नेवर एवर टू वेंचर इन टू द 13th फ्लोर नोन एज कोटाकॉम. ही वंस अगेन मीट्स वेज हु टेल्स हिम दैट ही इज लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू क्विटिंग हिज जॉब एंड सेटिंग डाउन विथ हिज आयरिश गर्लफ्रेंड. गजनी सेंड्स विकास एंड वेज ऑन अ सेगमेंट टू कवर किडनेप्ड जर्नलिस्ट इन वन ऑफ द टेररिस्ट अबू नजीर टेररिस्ट कैंप इन अफगानिस्तान. द टू मीट अबू नजीर ब्रदर खलील शबीर अलुवालिया हु ट्राइज टू स्केयर विकास बाय किलिंग वन ऑफ द किडनेप्ड जर्नलिस्ट एंड इज लेटर रिवील्ड टू बी गजनीज राइट हैंड. विकास शॉक्ड टेक्स एक्शन एंड फाइट्स खलील्स थग्स. खलील देन शूट्स वेज मल्टीपल टाइम्स लीडिंग टू दिस डेथ. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Owais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Owais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Owais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Owais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Owais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Owais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Owais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Owais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Ovi's death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then, India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. The curse confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes that trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zahra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zahra and rifled off a list of AI Zahra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zahra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zahra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. The curse confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India B. ब्यूरो। विकास इज गोइंग थ्रू ए डिवोर्स विथ हिज वाइफ अंजलि श्रेया सरन एंड गेटिंग हिज माइंड ऑफ थिंग्स। विकास एक्सेप्ट द ऑफर एंड फ्लाइज टू इस्तानबुल टू स्टार्ट वर्क फॉर AI जोहरा। विकास देन मीट्स डॉक्टर लीसा लोबो, श्वेता भारद्वाज एट द पार्टी। लीसा हु इज हेडेड टू इस्तानबुल टू अटेंड अ मेडिकल कनेक्शन एंड इट इज लेटर रिवील्ड दैट लीसा इज अ रॉ एजेंट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू रिक्रूट विकास। वंस इन इस्तानबुल विकास मीट्स विद द हेड ऑफ AI जोहरा एंड गजनी निकितिन धीर हु हैज बिजनेस इंटरेस्ट ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड बट हुज ऑब्सेशन दिस डेज इज AI जोहरा एज एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट टू शेप द वर्ल्ड इवेंट्स। There is only one word of caution to Vikas and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Wes on a segment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Wes multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Wes get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Wes' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Wes had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and settling down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, रिजवान खान, विवेक ओबराय, हु हिंट्स दैट नो सीनियर एम्प्लॉय हैज एवर क्विट एआई जोरा एंड रेफरल्ड ऑफ ए लिस्ट ऑफ एआई जोरा एम्प्लॉयज हु हैड बीन किल्ड इन टेररिस्ट अटैक विद इन डेज ऑफ देयर बीइंग ऑफ रूमर्ड ऑफ देयर प्लान्स टू क्विट और देयर रेज्यूम्स सर्कुलेटिंग इन द जॉब मार्केट बिकॉज मेंबर्स ऑलवेज हाइंड टेलिंग हिम दैट ही वॉन्ट्स टू क्विट हिज जॉब. दिस मेक्स विकास सस्पिशियस अबाउट एआई जोहरा being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Because confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalist and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan, Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces his son recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. The curse confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by Azora's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Wes on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists, and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Wes multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Wes get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Wes' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces his son recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. The curse confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zahra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. विकास देन मीट्स डॉक्टर लीसा लोबो श्वेता भारद्वाज एट द पार्टी लीसा हु इज हेडेड टू इस्तानबुल टू अटेंड अ मेडिकल कनेक्शन एंड इट इज लेटर रिवील्ड दैट लीसा इज अ रॉ एजेंट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू रिक्रूट विकास वंस इन इस्तानबुल विकास मीट्स विद द हेड ऑफ एआई जोहरा एंड गजनी निकितिन धीर हु हैज बिजनेस इंटरेस्ट all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and let's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohra and rifled off a list of AI Zohra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohra, and Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and let's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother खलील शबीर अहलूवालिया हु ट्राइज टू स्केयर विकास बाय किलिंग वन ऑफ द किडनैप्ड जर्नलिस्ट एंड इज लेटर रिवील्ड टू बी गजनीज राइट हैंड विकास शॉक्ड टेक्स एक्शन एंड फाइट्स खलील्स थग्स खलील देन शूट्स अवेस मल्टीपल टाइम्स लीडिंग टू दिस डेथ विकास जंप्स ऑन हेलीकॉप्टर एंड राइड्स अवे सीइंग अवेस गेट किल्ड reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days Ghazni finds out about Oves death and holds a funeral at the funeral Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market because members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job this makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zora being connected to terrorists and before asking any more questions Rizwan Khan disappears Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zora reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zora, especially when he seems to bump into strangers. Who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zora's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport documents and money all missing. Later on which while buying a Falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zora through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zora. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zora, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zora as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Ahluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas shocked takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists, and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes that trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zahra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zahra and rifled off a list of AI Zahra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zahra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zahra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, Who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI, Zohara, as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohra and rifled off a list of AI Zohra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a felatified roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Obese get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Obese's death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a felatified roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Obese get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Obese's death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zora reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zora, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorist attack. Because confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zora's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zora through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zora. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zora, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zora as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalist and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zora being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zora reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zora, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorist attack. Because confused accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zora's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghasnistan, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Wes on assignment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Wes multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Wes get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Wes' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Wes had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Johara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as कोटाकॉम। ही वंस अगेन मीट्स वेज, हु टेल्स हिम दैट ही इज लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू क्विटिंग हिज जॉब एंड सेटिंग डाउन विथ हिज आयरिश गर्लफ्रेंड। गजनी सेंड्स विकास एंड वेज ऑन असाइनमेंट टू कवर किडनैप्ड जर्नलिस्ट इन वन ऑफ द टेररिस्ट अबू नजीर टेररिस्ट कैंप इन अफगानिस्तान। द टू मीट अबू नजीर ब्रदर खलील शबीर आलूवालिया हु ट्राइज टू स्केयर विकास बाय किलिंग वन ऑफ द किडनैप्ड जर्नलिस्ट एंड इज लेटर रिवील्ड टू बी गजनीज राइट हैंड। विकास शॉक्ड टेक्स एक्शन एंड फाइट्स खलील्स थग्स। खलील देन शूट्स ओवेस मल्टीपल टाइम्स लीडिंग टू दिस डेथ। विकास जंप्स ऑन हेलीकॉप्टर एंड राइड्स अवे सीइंग ओवेस गेट किल्ड। रीलिंग एट हिज क्लोज एनकाउंटर विद टेररिस्ट एंड वॉचिंग ए ब्रूटल किलिंग विकास अराइव्स इन इस्तांबुल इन द डेज। गजनी फाइंड्स आउट अबाउट ओवेस डेथ एंड होल्ड्स ए फ्यूनरल एट द फ्यूनरल। विकास इज अप्रोच्ड बाय ए फॉर्मर तुर्किश कमांडो रिजवान खान विवेक ओबराय हु हिंट्स दैट नो सीनियर एम्प्लॉय हैज एवर क्विट एआई जोरा एंड राइफल्ड ऑफ ए लिस्ट ऑफ एआई जोरा एम्प्लॉयज हु हैड बीन किल्ड इन टेररिस्ट अटैक विद इन डेज ऑफ देयर बीइंग ऑफ रूमर्ड ऑफ देयर प्लान्स टू क्विट और देयर रेज्यूम्स सर्कुलेटिंग इन द जॉब मार्केट। विकास मेंबर्स ओवेज हैंड टेलिंग हिम दैट ही वांट्स टू क्विट हिज जॉब। This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Sweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Gazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Gazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Gazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces his soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vickers, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vickers goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by a Ghazni's man. While running from Ghazni's man, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then, India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zahara and rifled off a list of AI Zahara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zahara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zahara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces his soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by a Ghazni's man. While running from Ghazni's man, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and What he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zahra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, and Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zahra and rifled off a list of AI Zahra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zahra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zahra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, and Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and settling down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. विकास इज अप्रोच्ड बाय अ फॉर्मर तुर्किश कमांडो रिजवान खान विवेक ओबराय हु हिंट्स दैट नो सीनियर एम्प्लॉय हैज एवर क्विट एआई जोरा एंड रिफल्ड ऑफ ए लिस्ट ऑफ एआई जोरा एम्प्लॉयज हु हैड बीन किल्ड इन टेररिस्ट अटैक विद इन डेज ऑफ देयर बीइंग ऑफ रूमर ऑफ देयर प्लान्स टू क्विट और देयर रेज्यूम्स सर्कुलेटिंग इन द जॉब मार्केट विकास मेंबर्स ओवेज एंड टेलिंग हिम दैट ही वॉन्ट्स टू क्विट हिज जॉब This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalist and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces his son recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Because confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by Azora's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by a Ghazni's man. While running from Ghazni's man, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's man and removes that trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zahra through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zahra, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zahra as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalist and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zahra and rifled off a list of AI Zahra employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zahra being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zahra reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zahra, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces his son recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zahra's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by a Ghazni's man. While running from Ghazni's man, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zahra. विकास देन मीट्स डॉक्टर लीसा लोबो श्वेता भारद्वाज एट द पार्टी लीसा हु इज हेडेड टू इस्तानबुल टू अटेंड अ मेडिकल कनेक्शन एंड इट इज लेटर रिवील्ड दैट लीसा इज अ रॉ एजेंट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू रिक्रूट विकास वंस इन इस्तानबुल विकास मीट्स विद द हेड ऑफ एआई जोहरा एंड गजनी निकितिन धीर हु हैज बिजनेस इंटरेस्ट ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड बट हुज ऑब्सेशन दिस डेज इज एआई जोहरा as an instrument to shape the world events there is only one word of caution to Vikas and let's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom he once again meets Wes who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend Ghazni sends Vikas and Wes on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas shocked takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Wes multiple times leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Wes get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Wes' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hand telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Wes had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and let's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Wes on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother खलील शबीर अहलूवालिया हु ट्राइज टू स्केयर विकास बाय किलिंग वन ऑफ द किडनैप्ड जर्नलिस्ट एंड इज लेटर रिवील्ड टू बी गजनीज राइट हैंड। विकास शॉक्ड टेक्स एक्शन एंड फाइट्स खलील्स थग्स। खलील देन शूट्स ओवेस मल्टीपल टाइम्स लीडिंग टू दिस डेथ। विकास जंप्स ऑन हेलीकॉप्टर एंड राइड्स अवे सीइंग ओवेस गेट किल्ड। Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Oves' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Ahluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on helicopter and rides away, seeing Oves get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorist and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Oves' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Uwais and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a felatified roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Wes, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Wes on a segment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Wes multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Wes get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Wes' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a felatified roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Johara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Johara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interests ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड बट हुज ऑब्सेशन दिस डेज इज एआई जोहरा एज एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट टू शेप द वर्ल्ड इवेंट्स. देर इज ओनली वन वर्ड ऑफ कॉशन टू विकास एंड लेट्स नेवर एवर टू वेंचर इन टू द 13th फ्लोर नोन एज कोटाकॉम. ही वंस अगेन मीट्स ओएस who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalist and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Uwais' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members always hind telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zohara reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then India Bureau. Vikas is going through a divorce with his wife Anjali Shreya Saran and getting his mind off things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world, but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas and let's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotakom. He once again meets Uwais, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Uwais on a segment to cover kidnapped journalist in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir's brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalist and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Uwais multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Uwais get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Oves' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zora and rifled off a list of AI Zora employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. 5 AI Zohara reporters before Oves had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zohara, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zohara's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away. And Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a felatified roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then Rizwan beats up Ghazni's men and removes the trackers. Rizwan tells Vikas that Abu Nazir is actually dead but being kept alive by AI Zohara through things. Vikas accepts the offer and flies to Istanbul to start work for AI Zohara. Vikas then meets Dr. Lisa Lobo, Shweta Bhardwaj, at the party. Lisa, who is headed to Istanbul to attend a medical connection, and it is later revealed that Lisa is a raw agent looking forward to recruit Vikas. Once in Istanbul, Vikas meets with the head of AI Zohara, Ghazni Nikitin Dhir, who has business interest all over the world but whose obsession these days is AI Zohara as an instrument to shape the world events. There is only one word of caution to Vikas, and that's never ever to venture into the 13th floor known as Kotacom. He once again meets Oves, who tells him that he is looking forward to quitting his job and sitting down with his Irish girlfriend. Ghazni sends Vikas and Oves on assignment to cover kidnapped journalists in one of the terrorist Abu Nazir terrorist camp in Afghanistan. The two meet Abu Nazir brother Khalil Shabir Aluwalia, who tries to scare Vikas by killing one of the kidnapped journalists and is later revealed to be Ghazni's right hand. Vikas, shocked, takes action and fights Khalil's thugs. Khalil then shoots Oves multiple times, leading to his death. Vikas jumps on a helicopter and rides away, seeing Oves get killed. Reeling at his close encounter with terrorists and watching a brutal killing, Vikas arrives in Istanbul in the days. Ghazni finds out about Oves' death and holds a funeral at the funeral. Vikas is approached by a former Turkish commando, Rizwan Khan Vivek Oberoi, who hints that no senior employee has ever quit AI Zohara and rifled off a list of AI Zohara employees who had been killed in terrorist attack within a days of their being of rumored of their plans to quit or their resumes circulating in the job market. Vikas members Oves and telling him that he wants to quit his job. This makes Vikas suspicious about AI Zohara being connected to terrorists. And before asking any more questions, Rizwan Khan disappears. Vikas discreetly runs a check on the name rattled off by Rizwan and discovers he was indeed telling the truth. Five AI Zora reporters before Uwais had either died in the car bomb explosion, abducted and killed, or simply found dead. He slowly notices that not everything as simple as it looks in the office of AI Zora, especially when he seems to bump into stranger who forces he soon recognizes as suicide bomber on a couple of terrorists attack. Vikas, confused, accidentally goes to the forbidden 13th floor of the building and is tortured by AI Zora's staff. Lisa arrives and saves him by talking him away, and Vikas goes back to his apartment only to find his passport, documents and money all missing. Later on, which while buying a falafel roll, he finds a note in his pocket telling him he is being followed by Ghazni's men. While running from Ghazni's men, Vikas bumps into Rizwan, who tells him he is being tracked wherever he goes and what he does. So then